Good Morning Bay Street is a production of TheUptrend.com and is for information and educational purposes only. The views and opinions expressed in this presentation are those of Stephen Whiteside and should not be considered personal investment advice. Always consult a qualified financial advisor before making any investment decisions. To learn more about the charts featured in this presentation, please visit TheUptrend.com. And now, here is Stephen Whiteside with today's newsletter.
Good morning, Steve Whiteside here with your daily market outlook for Friday, March 4th, 2011. Now, it's 9 a.m. on the East Coast. We've had the U.S. employment numbers out at 8:30. Previous to those numbers, the futures were flat. A half hour later, the futures are flat. So we're not seeing a lot of enthusiasm this morning, not a lot of follow through to the upside after the big update we saw yesterday. In my U.S. presentation, I talked about the fact I'm concerned about what happened yesterday. We've got some open gaps above where the market closed yesterday, and that should act as resistance. We also have an open gap below where the VIX is right now, and that is acting as support. Now, with the market up so sharply yesterday, you'd think the VIX would have dropped dramatically, and that didn't happen. And so we've got the VIX still on a buy signal, and we need it to close below 18.18 to give us a new sell signal on Friday. Of course, a new sell signal on the VIX would be supportive for higher stock prices. Now, not a lot of changes on the TSX. The commodities are still doing really well, and that is certainly holding up the TSX above the U.S. markets right now. The TSX is having trouble up at the previous resistance there, so that is a concern, but no sign of a sell signal on Friday. Looking at short-term market breadth for the TSX, you can see we're coming off a low this week, and that's hard to understand given the fact that the index itself is doing so well. How could market breadth be coming off lows? Well, we have a lot of stocks in the TSX 60 that just aren't doing very well at the moment. And so we've got stocks like Kinross, and there's other gold stocks that are not doing well right now. We've got Magna. We've got Rogers Communications. I'm just giving you a sampling across the board from several industries. TransAlta, George Weston's. So we've got a lot of stocks that aren't doing well. Now, they could do better if the market starts to turn around, but I'm not sure the market's going to be able to turn around. It's really a lot about commodities. And yesterday's activity was all about a couple of bank stocks like the Royal Bank and the TD Bank, which did very well yesterday. Taking a look at the energy sector, we've been treading water up here for the last couple of days. A close below 352.92 would give us a sell signal on Friday. Big up day for bank stocks yesterday. A close below 194.07 on Friday would give us a sell signal. Gold stocks once again came down to the lower channel line. Remember, it's a different market. There's gold and then there's silver. And silver is outperforming gold right now. We need to close below 729 on the silver index to give us a sell signal. The materials stuck up here at resistance, and it's hard to believe it, but this is like our third run at this particular level. We need to close below 435.86 on Friday to give us a sell signal. You can see we haven't been using resistance, our resistance numbers, to hold the market back. It's been doing it on its own. But somehow, some way, this is a line in the sand that the market's had trouble getting over the last couple of months. Looking at copper stocks, they came right up to very close to issuing a buy signal yesterday. Fertilizer stocks did issue a buy signal. We saw a buy signal in Agrium. Potash has been on a buy signal for a few days now. Looking at uranium stocks, they're still on a sell signal. Looking at the Venture Exchange, we've been on a buy signal for a couple of days now. A close below 2370.59 would change that on Friday. Looking at bonds, now bonds did turn over yesterday, so we had buy signals in the Dow and the S&P 500 and the NASDAQ yesterday, so we saw money flow into stocks and out of bonds. We need to close above 120.126 to give us a buy signal on Friday. No change for the Canadian dollar, no change for the U.S. dollar, continues to make lower lows heading towards 75. Looking at commodities, no changes on Thursday. We need to close below 440 in copper to give us a sell signal. 1399.13 for gold, 3226 for silver. Now, I get asked a lot about gold and silver, about silver bars, gold coins, silver coins, and what do I prefer? And investing in gold and silver as a long-term hedge or a long-term safety net for your family is a good thing to do. If you want to hedge a large amount of money, of course, the easiest way to do that is with gold bars. And gold bars are kind of hard to change, though. So, you know, if push comes to shove and the world hits the fan and currencies become worthless, then, you know, what are you going to buy with a big fat gold bar? So, you know, the first thing you're going to want to have is access to silver coins. And I would prefer, if you don't have anything and in the future you want to start, you know, putting money into actual precious metals, for you to own and store for a long time, not trade, not think about every day, not look at the price every day, but just to have as part of your long-term investment strategy, then I would prefer that you had bags of silver coins, because it's going to be a lot easier to walk into a store to buy some food with a pocket full of silver coins than it is some big gold bar that nobody's going to be able to want to change for you. So if you want to hedge big money, use gold. If you want to have walking around transaction money so you can survive if things get bad, then look at bags of silver coins. That's probably the best thing you can do. Moving forward, looking at crude oil, we need to close below 95.97. Natural gas, we need to close above 3.99 to give us a buy signal. Looking at 60-minute charts, looking at the pressure zone down at the bottom, that was the last low-risk buying opportunity on the TSX. We've shaken off an early warning signal that went off a couple of days ago, but have not been able to break out above the recent high. Looking downward, flypaper channel comes in just above 14,000. We would look at that area as support. Then, of course, we have the open gap to act as our next layer of support. Looking higher, we got stuck right at our price target yesterday. We needed to break out above 14,218. That would take us up to 296 and then 375 if the market wants to continue to move higher on Friday. Last up on the downside, first sign of weakness will be an hourly close below 14,165 on Friday. At that point, we'd see a new intraday sell signal, and we would expect the market to head lower from there. Okay, that's all for Friday morning, folks. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again on Monday morning.